And also do though is I can exclude particular folders. So I might choose that I don't want to back up this software volume and I don't want to back up the page file. So I have the ability to do those individual selections that I can click OK and I'll then get my list. What I can also do is I can actually do file masks, and so I can say if a file looks like this, then don't back it up. So if I go into my advanced settings, I can do this exclusion, and I'm going to select the C drive, and I'm going to choose to actually exclude a couple of different types of files. So the first file type I want to exclude is all temp files. I can then add in another exclusion, and this one I'm going to choose to actually exclude MP3 files. Now I can choose to do that for the entire volume as I've selected the C drive in here, or I can actually choose to exclude any subfolders. So I could go into one particular folder and exclude a particular type of file. So that's a great improvement which we didn't have before. So I'll click OK, that's going to save my settings for me. Once I'm happy with that, I can click on Next. I can choose when I'm going to schedule it. Once I've scheduled it, I can then choose where I want to back up to. For the original release, we had this first option, which is back up to a hard drive that's dedicated for backups. And when you select this, what will happen is the first time that drive is used, it will actually be reformatted and then your backups will be stored there. What's new for 2008 R2 is this backup to a volume and backup to a shared network folder. If I choose to back up to a volume, I don't need to dedicate an entire disk to the process. And what is also good is I can have other data on that volume. Now, it's not recommended because it's going to have a performance impact on the volume, but it's something that you can do. So you don't need to worry about having your volume reformatted every time you run a backup. The second option that's new here is this backup to a shared network folder. So I can now schedule a backup and have that backup stored on another machine. This was not something that I could do within the original release. So I'm going to choose that option of backup to a shared network folder. It's going to give me a warning and it's going to say when you do this, you can only keep the last backup. So that's fine. And here I need to specify my location. So I've created a folder on server 2 called backups, and that's where I'm going to do my backups to. The next thing I'm going to get asked is for credentials, and these credentials need to have permission on the local machine to actually run the backup, and then they also need to have permission to connect to that shared resource on the other machine. Once I'm happy with those settings, I'll click Finish. And once the job's been created, I can click Close. If I want to see that scheduled job, what I can do is I can go into the Task Scheduler. So to do this, I'll click on Start, and then I'll go into Admin Tools, and you'll see I have the Task Scheduler here. If you then dig down into the Task Scheduler library, you'll find underneath Windows and then Backup, this is where your job has been created. And if I open up the properties for this job, I can come in here, I can see the history of the job, so when it was created. Underneath the general, I can see what the actual credentials it'll be running underneath. Underneath the triggers, I can see when it's scheduled. Underneath the actions, I can see what it's actually going to be doing. And one of the important things here is that on the settings, they have the ability to enable this option, this allow tasks to be run on demand. So if you want to check this job and make sure it's going to work okay, then if you just enable that option, you can then come in here, you can right click and you can choose run. If you don't do that, then you'll get a little pop-up saying that the job hasn't been enabled for on-demand running. Returning to the Windows Server Backup console, I have the ability, in addition to doing my schedule backups, to also come in here and do a single one-off backup. And when you open the wizard, it'll ask you whether or not you want to backup using your schedule backup options or if you want to do different options. So here I can choose different options. I can choose to do, as an example, a full server backup, or again I can do my custom. And as I said before, if I choose to do a bare metal recovery, that will backup all of the critical volumes, it'll backup the system state for me, and I can then use that to do a bare metal recovery of the server. And that process involves booting up off a Windows Server 2008 R2 media and then telling it where to go and find the files to do the recovery from. When I'm performing a one-off backup, I have the same options I had before, so I can come in here, I can do file exclusions. When I choose my next, I can choose whether I'm going to back up to a local drive or if I'm going to back up to a remote shared folder. I can then specify which drive I'm going to back up to, so I can choose the E drive here. And once I'm happy with that, I can then hit backup, and then that's going to kick off the backup for me. That then is the backup side of the story. And of course, the other important side of this story is going to be recovery. So how do I restore files, and what are the options I have for restoring files? So if I click on the recover option, I can come in here and I can choose whether I want to recover the local machine or if I want to recover another server. So I'm going to click the local machine. I can then specify the day of when I actually want to do the recovery from. It will then let me choose if I want to recover individual files and folders, if I want to recover volumes, or if I actually want to recover the system state. Now, if I had an application installed that had registered with VSS, then I would have this applications option. But I'm going to choose the file and folders. What I can then do is when I click the select items to recover, I can then expand out my server and I can navigate the disk and I can go and choose a particular file or a particular folder to recover. I can then choose to restore it to its original location or to an alternate location. I can choose whether or not I want to overwrite an existing file or if I want to create additional copies. And I can also choose whether or not I want to restore the access control list for it. So once I'm happy with that, I can click next and then I can go and then actually perform the recovery. And it's all pretty quick. It's all straightforward and it's a great tool. That then wraps up this little video on configuring Windows Server Backup within Server 2008 R2. I hope you've enjoyed it, and be sure to watch out. I'm going to do another video in this series on actually doing this from the command line, so focusing on wbadmin and focusing on the PowerShell commandlets. My name's Gordon Ryan. Thanks for listening.